But there are other kinds of war, other challenges which must be met. We must have the flexibility, the balanced forces to meet them all. It takes a great many different types of weapon systems, skills, units, tactics to provide this vital flexibility. We have it. It means that our answer to challenge can be tailored to the nature and scope of that challenge. It means we don't have to use a sledgehammer to swat a fly. But if a sledgehammer is needed, at the same time, the challenges of tomorrow must be considered. One answer, the F-111, a design innovation full of promise, a fighter and bomber for both Air Force and Navy, whose wings can adjust their angle of sweep for top efficiency at high and low speeds. Another example, the SR-71, a long-range supersonic reconnaissance craft crammed with the most advanced observation equipment in the world. The Polaris A-3, the longest-ranged submarine ballistic missile, will soon be followed by Poseidon, now under development and promising 8 times greater effectiveness against the best-protected military targets. And the Nike X, the world's most advanced anti-ballistic missile system, now in development. First, a target missile is launched, and seconds later, a Nike Zeus is sent in pursuit. Eyes on the ground, watch an electronic indicator for the flash of light which will indicate a successful hit. So, under the guidance of the Joint Chiefs of Staff and the Secretary of Defense, the defense posture of the United States is carried forward dramatically. Nuclear warheads in our strategic forces have been increased 150%. A 200% increase in both the number and total megatonnage of nuclear weapons in the strategic alert forces. 100% increase in general ship construction and conversion to modernize the fleet. A 1,000% increase in special forces trained to deal with counterinsurgency threats. A 100% increase in airlift capability, a 67% increase in the tactical nuclear weapons deployed in Western Europe. A 51% increase in the number of tactical fighter squadrons, a 45% increase in the number of combat-ready army divisions. And all the while, in addition to these increases and others, the constant sharpening of the efficiency of our military manpower. All of this, the improvements, the new weapons and program, the polishing of military skills, are directed toward a single goal: readiness to meet any kind of challenge anywhere on Earth. Achieve this magnitude and flexibility of striking power costs money, yet at the same time, there has also been a far-reaching cost reduction program. Secretary of Defense McNamara